As it says, we're at the 79th Camellia show, December.
This is the 79th annual Pensacola Camellia Club Camellia show. We'll have somewhere in the neighborhood of 1,000 to 1,500 blooms today. From five states. We have growers and hobbyists from five states coming in. We've had a few cancellations due to bad weather. And they bring their flowers and we place them by their species and their size. Judges decide which ones win the blue ribbon in each category. And then the very best flowers in the show go to what we call the head table. And they vote for the best flowers in the entire show.
This is the prep room. Camellia enthusiasts bring to the room to prepare the camellias for demonstration. And each bloom is prepped individually. Cards are filled out regarding to size and variety. Then they're brought to the exhibit room and placed. Each variety is judged separately, and then blooms are selected by the judges for higher awards and go to what's known as a contention table. And we see the contention table here, and they're grouped according to size, etc., and other characteristics. And each category is judged separately, and all judges have to vote in the contention. There are teams of judges that do the initial judging and give the ribbons related to each variety. And you see here, each judge has a book related to the categories. That's the Bible for reference. And you see the ballots that they put in. It takes a lot of bookkeeping to select some of these. And sometimes you have to go back the second and the third time to vote. As you see, most of the judges have the identifying button card and blue ribbon. Voting at the contention table. As I said, it's a bookkeeping job for the clerks. Most of these judges are also camellia growers. Most are from out of town. We try not to use our own local for judges unless we're in a bind. We had two elements that were different. One was on the Friday night for our setup. President Trump came to town for a rally, and that changed the traffic pattern. And then on that evening. There was ice on the interstate, and I-110 was closed because there was ice on the overpasses. And a few of the judges that were going to drive from Mobile the night before turned around and went back. That made maybe an effect of less than 200 blooms that we normally would have had, but we had plenty of blooms, as you can see. Blooms are in two major categories. Greenhouse are protected, and those grown open are unprotected. And so each of those two categories are joined, are judged separately. And after a winner in each of these categories, as you see, there are ribbons that separate the different categories. Ribbons on the table. There's a ribbon. Then that winner in that section then goes to the head table for the major prize. A lot of bookkeeping, as you can see. Now we're at the head table, and this year we did Toys for Tots, and the winners will get a certificate, and then the Marines will pick up the toys for the kids. There is no song with Camellia in the title, but Billy Strayhorn's tune, "A Flower is a Lovesome Thing," would fit here. Most of the blooms have not come up. We'll see the head table will be filled with a bloom for every certificate you see there. Photography, all the blooms at the head table get a photograph, and so the bloom and the entry card get photographed first, and then second the bloom by itself. Okay, the refreshment table. Now we see a few blooms coming to the head table. The major winners get the certificate, and the ones with the plates are the local novice winners. Those people have not won major prizes before, so they compete in a separate category. our photographer helper comes and helps the photographer make photos, which are available on our Camellia Club website. Here's a tray of three with its title and also with the entry card telling what variety that is. Michael Spoonybarger, a nationally known photographer, local. He works also for the New York, as a stringer for the New York Times and some other major papers when they have stories in this area. Now, bookkeeping. A lot of bookkeeping going on to count the number of cards and what was in each category. The clerks all have these vests, as you can see. The American Camellia Society has a table. Now here's the head table with many of the prize-winning blooms exhibited. And Toys for Tots, the Marines will pick these up and deliver them appropriately to the kids. Here's a spray, as we just saw. Not all Camellia shows have that, but there's some variation, and we give a prize for the best spray rather than the individual bloom. Purple Dawn or Methodian, as you can see, that's a local favorite. And this is the novice category for people who have not won major prizes before. So they compete separately until they've won about three, and then they have to compete with the regular exhibitors. Pink Perfection is everybody's favorite. All right, this is an overview, more at the contention table, trying to finish up this this judging process takes a long time. Arturo, Art Conrick, is a chemical engineer who's also an excellent classical and jazz guitarist who played in the main room during the showtime. Not every Camellia show comes with music, but we thought it was a good idea.
Well, here we are at the Camellia show on Saturday, and we got a lot of Camellias. We had 1,331 blooms at the show. People from five states, six states maybe. It was a good show, and everybody's happy.